A mother is devastated to learn that her missing son has been shot and set on fire. Who would commit such a heinous crime and why?
Today marks the 25th birthday of Roberto Ayala Jr., who was found murdered on Tuesday, October 30th, 2018 at approximately 3:30 a.m. His body was discovered burning in a vacant field in the area of 23rd and Poplar Street on Detroit's southwest side. The day prior, Roberto's mother picked him up from a store located at Oakman and Ewald Circle, which was in an area of where he'd been residing. Around 3:15 p.m., she returned him to the same spot. She called him later around 6:30 p.m. He answered and said hello, but then the phone disconnected. Mom called back several times, but got no answer. 2 days later, she went on to file a missing persons report, but would later find her son at the morgue.
When I did this a year ago, it still didn't really feel real. I guess I was just like a robot on autopilot. And now, like, all the time and holidays and get-togethers that we've had in our family, it just doesn't seem right. My life is never gonna be the same. It's forever changed. I almost feel like I've been diagnosed with an incurable disease, because for the rest of my life, I'm gonna suffer.
This is the worst pain that I've ever had to go through, losing my best friend, my brother.
People, you know, these kids are getting just killed. They're killing each other, left and right, and they think that this, you know, it's funny, and they think it's cool because they got a murder on them and stuff. You know what? It's a shame, and this needs to stop.
There's times that out of nowhere I'll be fine, and then I can hear him calling my name. He didn't deserve to be shot and set on fire and left in a field. I can hear him calling me, asking me to save him. And this is all I have. I have to get justice for my son. I feel like he comes to me in my dreams because his soul can't rest until he knows that he gets justice.
In this case, I believe it was somebody that my brother had trusted. And it's a shame that, you know, people operate this way. It's a shame that people feel as though that they have to take someone's life, take someone away from their family. It's not fair. It's not fair at all, but don't get what's coming to them, you know.
And I know that there's somebody out there that knows something. And maybe you're just scared, but just put yourself in our shoes. If your uncle, your cousin, your father, brother, sister, if something happened to them and you thought that I might be able to help the police in catching the people that did such a horrible thing to your loved one, wouldn't you want me to come forward?
And don't forget, we will not stop until the person that did this or persons get caught. And you will get caught, that's for sure. You will get caught.
Crime Stoppers of Michigan is offering a cash reward of up to $2,500 for any information that leads to an arrest. We are asking that you please help this family by making an anonymous call to Crime Stoppers at 1-800-SPEAK-UP. You may also visit our website at 1-800-SPEAK-UP.org. And please remember that your identity will always remain 100% anonymous, and all rewards are paid in cash.